With all the people playing Apex right now, over 25 million, probably even higher than that, there's a pretty diverse crowd on the battlefield. But just like every other game out there, there's certain types of people who you are going to be running across and meeting more often than others. Certain types of Apex Legends players. What is up, everybody? Chaos here, and today we're going to look over 10 of those Apex player types that you're going to be meeting. So let me know, which one of these types are you, and which one do you not want to be? Drop a like, and let's go. This month's giveaway is for a new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is drop a like on this video, be subscribed to the channel, and turn on your notifications so you never miss an upload. And in the comment section, let me know why you want to win the PS4 and include your Twitter handle so I can contact you if you're the winner. The winner will be announced at the end of the month. The ability spammer at number 10, kicking off our list, is the player that you've probably seen a lot online. It doesn't matter what character they're playing as or what the situation is. They're going to be spamming that ability whenever they get the chance. If they're playing Pathfinder, they're going to be grappling every chance they get. If they're playing Mirage, they're going to be throwing decoys out left and right. If they're playing Caustic, they're going to be putting traps absolutely everywhere. Now, I'm not saying this isn't a good strategy, because in a lot of cases, it's actually pretty smart to just throw the abilities out whenever you have them. You can't take them back to the lobby with you, but we all know that one player who just spams their ability button for the sake of doing it. Open mic. Now, it can be really frustrating when you randomly queue into an Apex game and get a team of people with no mics, but it's even more frustrating when you get a team of people with open mics and you have to listen to everything going on in their house. This is such a strange phenomenon to me. People have been making fun of echo mics and open mic players ever since the Modern Warfare 2 days, and yet people, they still do it. How do you not notice that your mic is on and you're just broadcasting your life to the entire internet, or the lobby at least? It's almost like they're doing it on purpose at this point. Due to the fact that Apex Legends doesn't have a very easy to find mute button, the open mic players are all the more annoying when you stumble upon them. The sniper. Now, sniping in any battle royale game is tough, and Apex Legends is no exception. With that being said, it's extremely satisfying to land those long shots on people and then drop them from across the map. So naturally, there are going to be players who just want to do that. They'll grab a sniper and a scope, and then they'll sit back while their teammates go out into the fray and do all the hard work. Snipers can often change the tide of battle if they're a good shot, especially if you get a Kraber in your hand, but I think we all know that one annoying player who will just let their team go into harm's way and then give the excuse, "Oh, I was sniping. I was overwatching you." It's one thing to be a sniper, but it's another thing to be a coward disguising themselves as a sniper. Don't be the second one. The leader, the IGL, the in-game leader. We all know that one player in any team-based multiplayer game who will act like they are God's gift to video games and try to boss everybody around. They'll demand you follow them. They'll try to make all the plans out. They'll take first dibs on all the loot. Even if you're lifeline and you call in a care package, they'll take it all. You name it. People like this aren't always bad, and if they're actually a good player, they can actually be pretty helpful, but there are always the leader type players who just aren't good at what they do, and it just ends up being annoying, especially if they're not any good at the game. Don't be bossing people around if you're not actually good, and if you're the type of person to do this, at least have a little bit of self-awareness about it. The champion. Nothing makes your confidence shrivel up faster in a game like Apex Legends when you're loading into the map, and then you see the champion squad, and they've got something like 10,000 kills and a billion damage inflicted, and their card is filled up with all these crazy animated banners and character models. Then, if you actually get killed by them and get that player card up in your face afterwards, it just makes you want to put the game down and never touch it again. Some people are just really good at games in general. Some people are really freaking good at this video game, and part of the driving factor to getting really good is the fact that the game will pretty much give you free advertisement before the match and whenever you get a kill. And actually, in the game, banners are all over the map, which is a cool thing, even though I really don't look at them very often. So, what are the best champion stats that you have run across so far in Apex Legends? The finisher at number 5. Now, some people just love to rub their victories in their enemy face. And I'm not gonna lie to you, lately, I've been a little more spicy with my finishes. I've probably had some suspect finishes where I should have been in a fight, but I just wanted to do it. Now, the finishers in Apex, they're a pretty awesome addition to the game, and they really spiced up the gameplay. But we all know that one player who does them every chance they get, and they've probably gotten killed for it more times than they would like to admit. Because of how team-based and communication-heavy Apex is, it is pretty much impossible to do a finisher on someone and not be called out to their teammates to come punish you for it. But people still do it, just to rub it in. The finishers are really cool, but at least have the self-awareness to not do it every single time, because I kind of like the balance Apex put in with this. You're going to be able to finish them, you're going to be able to embarrass them, but you're going to be literally frozen in those animations for about 3 to 4 seconds. And I've seen plenty of clips already of somebody coming in and mule kicking or sucker punching somebody in the face and right out of their finisher. And I think it's hilarious. The Mozambique Defender. These people, well, they're rare in the Apex Legends community, but they are real. And they are very, very confusing to me. The Mozambique is a pistol that is trash, and 99% of people will agree with this. Let me know if you agree or disagree in the comment section, but there's still that 1% of people who will defend this little shotgun pistol as an underrated weapon that you just have to be good with. You hate on it because you're no good with it. Look, I know that in just about every multiplayer shooter, there's going to be a niche weapon, and there's also going to be crappy weapons that people still enjoy using. Trust me, anytime I ever mention the F2000 from Modern Warfare 2, and if it's a bad weapon, or if I mention the Cheekum from Black Ops 2, people come at me in droves and say it's the best weapon in the world. But can we please stop defending the Mozambique? Let it get buffed, and then let's move on with our lives. It is trash, and if people keep defending it, it's never going to get the buff that it actually needs. And it does not help that the drop rate is literally out of control with these things. The Solo Lander. Apex is a very team-focused game, which is why you're forced to play with a team of three. However, due to a lot of people solo queuing a lot, and also due to people really wanting a solo playlist, make it happen, respawn, we've all had that annoying teammate who we get paired up with who will just fly off on their own without a word to their teammates and go play a solo match and leave you and your other teammates to fend for yourself. Now, on one hand, I can't really blame people for doing this. After all, if Respawn isn't going to give solo players a chance to play by themselves or a choice, what else are they going to do? But then on the other hand, it's pretty crappy to join into a lobby and then just leave your teammates behind, especially in a team-based game like Apex where a 1v3 is hard to beat. Don't be that player. Just bite the bullet and play with them until the solo playlist comes along. It's only a matter of time at this point before we get it. I promise. I can't promise, but I semi-promise that it's coming. The Pinger, the one who pings everything. Pinging is awesome, and it's a great addition to the game that makes it easier to communicate, but holy crap, you do not have to ping everything. Now, I love being able to just hit a button and let somebody know where the enemies are and communicate without having to have a mic, where the loot is, where a good gun is, where that Mozambique is, so on and so forth. But there are people out there who seem to like the pinging feature a little too much, and they will literally ping every single little thing they see, whether it's a rock or a rope or some water. Light ammo here, standard stock here, optics here, Mozambique here, shotgun ammo here, let's go this way, never mind, med kit here, I need this, I need that. Over and over and over for the entire match. Just chill. Chill with the ping button. Use it when it needs to be used and don't overdo it. Then again, it's actually it's a troll button as well. And at number one today, the newbie Pathfinder. Now, is it just me or do all the noobs play Pathfinder? And I play with Drifter every day and he plays Pathfinder. He's obviously not a noob, but anyway, I can't be the only one who's noticed this. Pathfinder is a very popular character due to his grapple hook, his fast mobility, and very high skill ceiling. But I can't be the only one who has noticed that whenever you play with someone who has never touched the game before and is the ultimate noob and doesn't know how to even walk forwards or backwards, guess what? They're playing Pathfinder. Now, due to him being a very lighthearted character with very straightforward abilities, a lot of new players will gravitate towards him. But there's also just something about the way he talks and he moves that makes noobs using him look even more newbie. And he has really tiny feet. They weird me out. I know he's a robot, but have you ever looked at his baby feet? We're talking like Deadpool baby feet when Deadpool's legs got cut off. I'm obviously not saying everyone using Pathfinder is a noob, but I can't be the only one who has noticed that all the super noobs seem to use Pathfinder. There you have it, my friends. Those are 10 types of Apex Legends players. Which one are you, and which one do you try to avoid at all costs? If you guys enjoyed the video, take a second, drop a like, let me know what your main is in Apex. Make sure you subscribe, turn on those post notifications, and I'll see you soon.